This is Flags for Worship and our home in Macon, Georgia. If you're looking for a house, it's for sale. We'd love to sell it to you.
See how I shine with surging the edges with the baby lock serger? This is a prep before she actually does the other sewing machine part of the job. And then I do the pose. This is Sharon hemming the flags on the second stage of the flags. If you look closely, you can see the edge that she's doing. Okay.
This is Keith's workbench. He has a grinder that he grinds the ends of the poles so they're real smooth. And he has all kinds of tools. And this is how he does the flags. This is a dowel. That one happens to be about 9 inches long. Then he's got spacers and ends that he also polyurethanes, and he uses brass screws. He countersinks these dowels that are, he's reamed them out so that they're really nice and smooth and there's no rough edges. Here he is screwing on the end of this purple satin flag. It's a very pretty flag. We'd like to thank you for watching our little video. Keith and I enjoy making worship flags. We started making them after I made worship flags for me to use at church. And then I started making some for my niece. And after I did that, people started saying, well, will you make one for me? And so I made some and I sell them at conferences. I've also done a lot of research on colors and flags, and that was for myself, and then I put it on a website so other people could use it, and then my boss suggested I put it in a book. So this is my book. It's called Biblical Uses of Colors and Flags, and we also sell that on our website. We'd like to ask you to come and see our website. All the information in my color book is on the website. And the booklet is only for your convenience so that you have it at church. And so we just want to thank you for visiting with us today. And we really enjoy making the flags. I tease Keith that the poles are too pretty to cover up with a flag. But he enjoys doing it. And he's real careful that the ends are real smooth and that there's no rough places. And so thank you for visiting with us today, and God bless you.